For several years, the Ugandan judiciary has been grappling with case backlog, with thousands of case files pending for many years. Several initiatives have been designed to ensure that they solve this problem. Notable among these initiatives is plea bargaining, mediation, as well as innovations such as the electronic case management system, among others. Releasing the annual performance report for the year 2022-2023, the judiciary reported a remarkable growth in the rate of case disposal, as Chief Justice Alphonse Owen Dolo explained.
A disposal rate of 63.01% in financial year 2022/23 was achieved, as compared to 55% in the previous financial year and 49% in the year preceding the previous financial year.
The report also indicates a remarkable growth in the number of cases disposed of. These rose to 266,323 in the year 2022-2023 from 205,969 in the year 2021-2022. Majority of the disposed cases came from the Chief Magistrate's Courts, followed by the High Court and the Grade 1 Magistrate Courts. The performance ratio of judicial officers has also greatly improved, giving hope for better results in future.
The number of cases registered and completed were recorded at the Chief Magistrate's Courts. This can be partly attributed to the increased staffing levels at the Chief Magistrate's Courts. The magisterial courts are the base of the judiciary pyramid. It is the largest population of judicial officers, and then it narrows and comes to the tip of the pyramid when you come to the Supreme Court. So understandably, in terms of numbers, they've made overwhelmingly impressive contribution.
These successes have been attributed to factors such as improved court infrastructure, especially in the hard-to-reach areas like islands, increased number of judicial officers, among others. However, the limited funding, inadequate courtrooms, and other infrastructure challenges still stand in the way for total elimination of case backlog. As per the statistics, 156,349 cases are still pending settlement.
The percentage of court users rating confidence in courts has increased from 61% to 71%. According to a survey done by Avocat Sans Frontières, Advocates Without Borders.
In his speech, the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao, commended the Chief Justice for changing the face of the judiciary, mainly by fighting hard to reduce case backlog, improving ethics and integrity of judicial officers, among other achievements.
You have a clear organizational vision and mission, and you're focused on empowering the workforce. My lords, allow me the latitude to call you a workforce, despite the many things you do. But when I say the workforce, it means the judicial officers and also the non-judicial officers. The empowerment is through better terms and conditions and also knowledge. Thanks to initiatives like the Judicial Studies Institute, the Ugandan judiciary has become a learning organization.
Mao, however, implored judicial officers on ethics and integrity, as well as ensuring equity in the dispensation of justice.
Today you face the challenge of managing change and continuity. I congratulate you again on behalf of the Ministry of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, and I pledge my continued support to ensure that you serve the Ugandan people to the best of your ability.